three, two, one. Good afternoon from a chilly College Park. Maryland dominates Notre Dame down the stretch to take this one. It was a top 10 matchup. Maryland came in 7. Notre Dame was 5. I'm Wayne Viner. This is Bruce Posner. Bruce, what'd you see out there?
I saw a dominating effort, a game that Maryland should have won by much more than it did. And we got to say the MVP today was Justin Shockey. He just controlled the game for Maryland. Notre Dame never had the ball enough to get back into it. And the goalie, Logan McEnany, yeah. Freshman, yeah. Quiet kid.
From Connecticut.
Did he play?
And we're number 30 for the Terps, but he steps in and goal. Logan Wisnowskis scored once again, taking very few steps. He gets the ball, he scores. The freshman sent him up. Dylan Maltz a couple times. It's a great looking passing game for Maryland today.
Yeah, one goal and 3 assists for Moss as a freshman, and Logan had 4 goals. I think Bernhardt had 2, and the rest were kind of spread out to some of the midfield. Maryland did not shoot well today. I know it sounds crazy. They scored 14 goals, but they just had a ton of shots that were errant, too high, too low. But all that being said, 14-9 of the number 5 team in the country, which I think maybe was a little high.
What, you know, they were a little
Dame
overrated
was, yeah.
At 5? Look, Costabile for Notre Dame,
great.
For 26. He cut through the Maryland defense a couple times. He was the only consistent weapon that Notre Dame could come up with. But you're right, you don't have the ball, it's hard to score.
Yeah, it was one of those games, and Maryland got off to a good start. And you said to me at halftime, hey, we're winning.
We're winning. We're not losing.
Right. It was by 1 goal and they were winning.
Right.
Best game they played this year. I did talk to Coach Tillman before the game, and he said he felt good about the game.
If you've been hurt in a truck crash, call the Jackledge Law Group. We have decades of experience handling truck crashes. We recognize issues unique to trucks, including black box findings and DOT regulations. We find insurance others don't know exists. Some think the only coverage is with the truck. Yet we've found millions more insurance with the broker. It's important to collect information and find representation immediately. Truck cases are complex. If you've been hurt in a truck crash, call 855-BIG-DOG-1 right now.
Let's go back to that. Maryland goes in the halftime at 7-5.
Right.
10:50 left in the third quarter at 7-7. And then Maryland outscores them 7-1. And most of that's on the goalie.
Yeah.
Most of that's on the face-off.
7-2, yeah. Face-offs and some great saves by the goalie when they did get shots off. But bottom line is Maryland's now 4-1, and what the heck, Yale lost to UMass. You know, Penn State and Penn were tied. Hopkins 16-8. Now they got to play Syracuse, who we talked to Terry Foy, could be number one.
They could. He said he'd vote him number one.
Right.
Albany comes in. That used to be a month.
I didn't even know. Are they doing any good this year? Syracuse came down raving mad because the Maryland wouldn't go north because of this weather,
yep.
And they took it to the Terps 10-5. So it's 1-3 for the Lady Terps. Yeah,
Kathy Reese, that's a highly unusual.
Well,
start.
7 ACLs can do that to you.
A lot of lost knees, a lot of lost players. We're going to get inside and try and beat the weather ourselves. Coach Tillman will be up in a minute.
Real quick for a minute, what was your synopsis of game day? You were
game
there,
day?
I wasn't.
Oh, it was a great Maryland party. The chants, the signs, Scott Van Pelt shows up, the pep band, the cheerleaders. You couldn't really hear it in the building. Part of that might be that I'm older. But there were so many people, so many cheers, and so many chants that very few parts of the program you could hear. But I'm so happy I got to go.
Are they up on the flash mob tonight? Tonight's flash mob night.
Yeah, I don't know what they're doing. But, yeah, it's flash mob you. The white T-shirts are out in Xfinity Center for all the students. I'm going to go to Bentley's. You're going someplace else. So I'll meet up at the Xfinity Center.
We'll be there
o'clock.
After the game and with our wrap-up. And hopefully the talking of the clinching of the Big East, Big Ten title.
Big Ten.
That would be something special.
All right.
But day's off to a great start with a 14-9 win by the Terps over
Notre Dame. This has been the Big Dog postgame show. Thanks to Rick Jacklich, Viner Forgates, Meyer Consulting Engineers. And you're going to hear more about Route 1 Apparel as time goes on. But welcome to Route 1 Apparel, our new sponsor.